Please, Mr. Zuckerberg, just one more loaf of bread, please.
During the course of their lectures, economics professors will occasionally discuss the topic of hyperinflation. I assure them that hyperinflation is short-lived. Inevitably, they reply, on what grounds do I base this erroneous conclusion? I simply ask, how many riots have they been through? Many scholars have written articles and publications on how the fear of longer prison sentences will curtail crime. Fear of incarceration is not a deterrent. The ability to commit crime is diminished only during the period of incarceration, assuming the prisoners have no outside contact or contact with other inmates. One can conclude that these scholars have neither lived or worked in the projects. As a dear friend used to say, I just patched up another Stockton and Knife Gun Club member, for the second or third time. If the threat of daily death is not a deterrent, what makes them believe longer sentences will quell their ways? Having worked in the projects for 22 years and personally witnessed the Watts, East LA, and LA riots firsthand, I can say something has changed. There are fewer opportunities now, but there are more homeless and gang members. As the middle class security buffer between the rich and the poor grows more narrow, and the former middle class join the disenfranchised, the elite now find themselves the object of crime at every level. Those high-achieving woke students must have heard John Dillinger say, that's where the money is. As America's ambassador Rahm Emanuel would say, this is the new normal. America's forsaken generations and soon to be razor-thin middle class foretell the future. You do not have to be clairvoyant to see what's coming. Common sense will do. In fact, the future is before us now. These carpetbaggers will be well armed.
I feel a tempest in the wind. I believe a storm is brewing around the bend. Darkness now shrouds the skies with poverty in its eye. There is no turning back, for your governance has stacked the rack. The scales have swung the other way, and America is now in full decay. Checkmate. Game over.
You can always trust Uncle Sam.
Well, let's see what's going on in the Epic Times today. It would appear that the stay on mass nationwide evictions has been lifted. My, the number of eviction filings is quite staggering, isn't it? Looks like at least 500,000 or more are destined for the streets. The benefits of mass evictions are already apparent. Do you see a trend forming? I believe your fire insurance is going to get prohibitively expensive. When Obama told you that there would be a redistribution of wealth, the only thing he neglected to tell you is that it would be at gunpoint.
Well, under Joey's watch, America's demise is assured.